Let us discuss an example. It says in the system shown in figure, if block A is pulled toward right at acceleration A, we are required to find the acceleration of the block B. Here, in the situation which we can see, if block A is going toward right, we can see the string which is connected to the block A will also be pulled toward right, as well as this pulley will also be going toward right. Say block A goes toward right by distance X. We can say this string will be pulled by distance X and this will also be pulled by distance X. So the length of a string only up to this point of pulley will be extended by 2X. And obviously as a string is tied up over here, this block B has to go up with a distance 2X. Then only it is possible that the string will remain tied. Because here the length is elongated or extended by 2x, so B has to move up along the surface of A by distance 2x. Now in this situation, if A is going toward right, we can say B is going up relative to the surface of A with the acceleration 2a. As in constraint relations, we have studied whatever is the relation among displacement, the same relation exists in acceleration also. So, if we talk about the acceleration of block B, we can simply state acceleration of block B can be calculated by vector sum of these two accelerations, because if this block B, it is going along the surface of A with an acceleration 2A, which is at an angle theta with the horizontal. If we resolve it in two parts or two components, horizontal will be 2A cos theta, but along with this, along with A, body A, B is also moving with an acceleration A toward right. So in X direction, the acceleration of block B can be written as A plus 2A cos theta. A is due to the acceleration of A, 2A cos theta will be due to the horizontal component of its acceleration on the surface of A. In Y direction, it is moving only due to this inclined motion, that is 2A sin theta. So acceleration of block B can be written as root of ax square plus ay square. Now we can easily get the magnitude of acceleration of block B. Here it can be written as a square into 1 plus 2 cos theta whole square plus it is 2a sin theta whole square. When you open it, we can see this a square will be as it is plus it will be, you can see 4a square cos square theta plus 4a square sin square theta will become plus 4a square plus one more term which will be left over here will be 4a square cos theta. Now if we take this a common out, we'll be having it is root of 5 plus 4 cos theta. This is the answer to this question, which is the acceleration of block B.